Welcome to my channel. My name is JB. There's a dog barking in the back. Welcome back if you've been here before. Nice to meet you if you're new here. Today, I'm gonna do a get ready with me type of video. I'm going to a day party, so I'm gonna do a little makeup tutorial, curl my hair, and then I'll show you guys my outfit. Before applying makeup, skin prep is so important, so I just did my daytime skincare routine. I will say that my skin type is definitely acne prone and combination. I do have oily and sensitive skin because I have rosacea, so sometimes my skin is very textured, but I've gotten a lot of compliments on the foundation that I use, so let's just get into it. I'm gonna start off with a concealer. I actually don't use primer. I never really got into using primer. I just prep my skin with my skincare and that works. My makeup holds all day pretty much. I don't think I look that busted by the end of the day. I use the e.l.f. Hydrating Camo Concealer Satin Finish. It's in medium peach. I just kind of put it where I have redness. Okay, we're gonna just dab that on for coverage. Yeah, this one works really well for me. It's drugstore, so it's super cheap. I think it works well underneath my foundation. Next up, we have foundation. I use the Bare Minerals Bare Pro. I use the shade Sandstone. I've been using this for years. It has the perfect amount of coverage, I think. I get a lot of compliments on my foundation, actually, which means a lot to me because I've grown up with textured skin, but this foundation that I use works really well for like a seamless finish. I'm gonna blend it a little bit down the neck so it looks more even. I do have my eyebrows done. I did ombre powder, got it done 2021 and retouched it last year. I actually don't do my eyebrows. It's an investment that I think is worth it because it was essentially my longest makeup step. Now, all I do is I take this brush, my makeup, and I just line it up. Getting my brows done, so worth the money. It did cost $500 to $600, and then the retouch was like $200. I got it done in the Bay, and I just blend it out with this fluffy brush. I'm by no means a makeup guru or anything. I think I know like the basics of doing makeup, and I don't look awful after, so there's that. So I don't do this stuff all the time, but because I'm going to a day party, I'm trying to look a little bit more put together than normal. I use this Revlon Photo Ready Concealer just to brighten up certain areas, like the corners of the lip, under eyes, and then down my nose. Now what I do is I take a Q-tip and I just get it a little bit wet so I can remove the foundation concealer that's on my lips and my eyebrows. Use the other side. Alright, so I'm gonna go into contouring. I use this Morphe face palette and this Jaclyn Hill blush bronzer. My palettes are effed up, but looks like this. These palettes are ran through, guys. It looks like this. So I just use the contour shades and mix it with the bronzer and create a beat, some type of beat, you know? So I use these three, this one, just mix my shades or whatever. And then I go under the jawline just to snatch it up a little, define it, and we're gonna blend it out after. So don't worry. For my cheeks, I use this one, it's fluffier. Go upwards. So it's not blended out yet. And I do my nose contour. I do under the tip on either side of which. And then I do this. So let's blend. And then blending out the nose contour. I use powder-based products because I have oily skin and I feel like they just work better. I'm gonna blend. My bronzer, my contour, whatever. I'm gonna do some blushies. I only started adding blush to my makeup routine last year. Game changer, I'm telling you. If you're not using blush, you fucking start. And the cheekbones. I'm gonna like tap the excess on the back of my hand, but I'm kind of just pat upwards. Look like I'm shy, you know? Like someone called me out on my bullshit. I'm just like, me? I'm all hot and bothered, flustered. I'm just gonna go in to like blend it a little together. Alright, let's snatch it up a little by cleaning it up with some powder. I like to use the translucent Maybelline Fit Me for my nose. And then this is also what I use for powder. Use the opposite side of my blending sponge. And then I use my Morphe translucent setting powder under my contour and then my eyes just to kind of set it. It helps make my makeup look more seamless. Only recently started doing it. I don't even know what I'm doing, but it works for me. I'm gonna use setting the under eye. I look so funny right now. Like, let's just acknowledge that. Do I look scary? Is this gonna scare the hoes? I don't even leave it on for that long, to be honest. Let's get rid of the excess. Sometimes I'll just blend a little over with my beauty blender. And if I feel like I need a little more blush, I'm gonna use a little more blush. My face is almost done, guys. I'm gonna do highlighter now. I like to use Fenty, little Fenty. Mean Money or Hustla Baby. Looks like this. We hit pan, guys. She done. I like to use this one because it's like a gold base, but I kind of mix them together too. Highlight that shit. And then I take my highlighting brush and get this part of my face. I can't fucking sing. Why am I trying to erase that from your memory? My makeup is almost done. Let's do eyeshadow. I use this Jaclyn Hill palette. She's seen me at my best and my worst. You can see we hit pan some of them. I'm going to do like some pink shades today. So I'm probably gonna do these and some of this. Just this like section. Use the lighter pink shade and put them with this fluffy ass brush in my crease. Obviously, I do have lash extensions. I wear eyeshadow with them. And I like putting on a wing liner. I'm gonna go in with this brush, the darker pink shade, a little bit underneath. So you can see, add a little bit of dimension or whatever makeup people say here. Some depth, blend it out a little lighter shade. Brushing up my lashes. I just like to use like the same shades essentially and kind of line my lower lash line. We're getting somewhere, y'all. The hardest part, my least favorite part, is the wing. I always get the angles wrong, but I use this NYX makeup. It's in dark brown. I'm gonna try it, guys. Always get the angles wrong. Okay, let's start there. Not bad. Okay. So I just like to do only on the outer thirds of my eye, but once I get a wing going, I just like to draw it out. A little wing. I don't like to go too crazy either. I'm not really good at this. All right, so I think my face is finished actually. Let's go over it with some powder. Setting spray. I swear on my life for this shit. Urban Decay All Nighter. I just douse my face like I'm drowning and my makeup lasts all day pretty much. And we let that shit dry and we're done. Actually, just kidding. I just forgot about my lips. How could I? What I like to do is I like to moisturize them first. I tend to use lipsticks. Easy to apply. I hate having chapped lips. I feel like you can rarely find me with them. My friends, correct me if I'm wrong. I don't use a lip liner all the time. I can just use one. This is Morphe Sweet Tea. And then I go in with NYX Lingerie Push-Up Long Lasting Lipstick. Looks like this. I like using it. I tend to go for shades that are variations of this. Just what I feel like looks best with my face, my makeup, and my skin color. I like to go over with Miss Fenty Beauty over here. Always been using this. It is very sticky and thick, but I love using it, so. Where is the complete look, guys. But I have to do my hair.